From the gateway to showbiz glory, this is Hollywood 411.
The CBS drama NCIS has earned its bragging rights. This week's season premiere had nearly 18 million viewers. Joining us now is one of the stars of the show, Rocky Carroll, who plays director Leon Vance. So welcome to the show, Rocky.
Thank you.
Pleasure having you here.
Nice to be here.
What a season premiere. 18 million viewers. You're a series regular now. What does that feel like to get this kind of response on a long-running show?
Most of them were at my house to watch the premiere, too.
Big family?
Yeah, yeah. It was great. It was terrific.
Right? You know? So we're going to be seeing you a lot more this season.
I'm going to be around this season. It's great. You know, the show is now in its sixth season, and usually, especially in this day and age of television, six seasons is usually, you know, you kind of leveled off or you start to take a dip the other way, but
right?
They're still, the numbers are still going up. The viewership's going up, and hopefully the quality of the show is going up as well.
Well, you guys are doing something right, that's
something
for
right.
Sure.
Yeah.
There's so much drama and tension and mystery in this show. Now, at the end of last season, you thought that you found the mole, but the viewers know that you were mistaken, right? So is that going to be plaguing you all season?
Well, I think what it's going to lead for is some very interesting interaction between myself and Gibbs,
yes.
The team, because my character, Vance, had broken up the team and sent all the other stars from NCIS into different various locations.
Yes.
I think we're going to mine as much gold out of that as we can as far as how they all come back, who the mole eventually is. There's going to be some tense moments between Gibbs and Vance because of this whole scenario.
Now, Gibbs is, of course, played by Mark Harmon, who
yeah.
you've worked before with on Chicago Hope.
That's
so
right.
What is this like? You know, now you're his superior. You guys
right.
worked together before on a different show. What's it like playing these scenes and sparring with him rather than scrubbing in with him?
Well, you know, I guess the real testament is that he and I hadn't worked together since Chicago Hope.
Right.
But the moment I started working with him again, it was like no time had elapsed. You know, it's right. still... Even though the characters are very sort of mano a mano and there's a lot of tension, it's like, it's a lot of fun. If you could see us between takes, which is usually the case,
yeah.
and the sign of a very good a good set and a good group of people, we have a lot of fun.
A lot of joking on set. I like to hear
yeah,
that.
Playing tough guys. We have a lot of fun.
Okay, so, but your character, right, we don't really know whether he's a good guy or a bad guy. I mean, which would you rather play?
Well, you know what? It's funny because... people say the bad guy. I guess he's a bit antagonistic with regard to Mark Harmon's character, but they're
yes.
both on the same side of the coin.
Okay.
You know, to me, it's kind of the black and white, you know, the good guy, the guy in the white hat, and the bad guy who wants world domination or wants mm-hmm. to destroy the world.
Right, these but it's
guys,
not like that.
No, but he's an authority figure. And I really
yes.
get a kick out of, like, when I meet people on the street,
yeah.
because you get a sense of what everybody's view of authority is. Some people
huh.
have some serious authority issues because it's like, He represents the authority figure. He's that guy. There's a little bit of, you know the leader, and there's a little bit of the Simon Cowell. It's like, I don't care what you think about me
right.
as long as you do your job.
Do you get some strange comments from these people that come up to
I
you on
do
the
get
street?
Strange
what do they
comments.
Say to you?
They do. They go, you know what, I don't like you. I don't like working for you. I said, well, you know, I appreciate that. It means I'm doing my job.
I must be doing
I must
something
be doing
right.
My job. It's a lot of fun. I tell people, you just have authority issues. That's all it is.
Let's talk about your new film to shift gears a little bit
right.
here. You've got this great film with a guy that you guys may have heard of, Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey, he's
yeah,
been
a little
around.
Small star there. You're going to be in Yes Man, a comedy,
yeah.
so switching
right.
gears a little bit. Can you tell us a little bit about that and what your role's like?
Well, it's funny. I get to play Jim Carrey's boss.
Oh,
so
must be something about you, Rocky.
You know, as long as they're workplace comedies or workplace dramas, you got to have a boss. So,
that's
you
right.
know, I'll take it. Jim Carrey... who actually he and I were both on the Fox network. I was in the series Rock, and he was in Living Color.
Right.
And along with Martin and Living Single in the early 90s, that
sure.
was the Fox, sort of the Fox Sunday night lineup.
Yeah.
So that was the first time I had met him. I think it was around 1990, 1991. And
wow.
he is, you know, he
he's
is
done
Jim
all right
Carrey.
For himself.
He's done
you know
pretty
what I'm
good
saying?
For himself, yeah.
All right, well, you're doing pretty well for yourself, too. It's a
Thank
pleasure
you.
Having you in, Rocky.
My
Thanks
pleasure.
For coming. The next, the new episode of NCIS is Tuesday on CBS at 8, 7 Central. Mark, are you going to be watching your NCIS this season?
Absolutely. Good to see Rocky yet again.
Absolutely.
All right, thanks, Rocky.